Now that we've talked about several different types of studies, we need to really think about actually collecting data. So let's concentrate on some sampling techniques. There will be three different sampling techniques that we're going to talk about, and I'll do a separate video on each one of them. The first one is commonly referred to as a simple random sample. It's a random sample selected in such a way that every possible sample of size n in the population is equal probability of being chosen. Now, some quick notation. Typically use capital N. This represents the population size. Little n represents our sample size. So when we say a sample of size n, we're talking about little n. That's the sample size. Now, the most obvious example is like lottery sampling. In lottery sampling, it's not just the lotto that you may see on TV or you may buy a ticket for every now and then. That is definitely a lottery. But lottery sampling, as an example, say there's 35 people in a class, and I assign the numbers 1 through 35, and then I simply take a sample of, say, three of those numbers randomly selected, and those three people that are chosen, something special happens. You know, they get an extra credit point or something, I don't know, just whatever. Now, the key here is that the likelihood of each possible sample of the same size being chosen are the same. So, in this case, I said n equals 3, and capital N equals, well, I think it's 35. So, that means that every group of 3 in this 35 are equally likely. Well, there's a bunch of groups of 3. So, say here's person number 1, person number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all the way up to person number 35. Now, obviously, the very first three people, 1, 2, 3, that is one possible group of 3. Likewise, the first person, the third, and the fourth, that's another possible group of 3. Likewise, the first person, the fourth, and the fifth, that's another possible group of 3. The first person, the fifth, and the sixth. And I can keep right on going. And maybe the next time around, I'm going to skip the first one and start off with the second, third, and fourth person. And then from there, go to the second, fourth, and fifth person. And then from there, move on to the second, fifth, and sixth person. And I think you can see that there's just a boatload of possibilities here. Now, if you actually want to figure out how many there are, we'll go into this a little bit later, but we can write this as 35 choose 3, which is the same as 35 factorial divided by 3 factorial. And if you don't speak factorial, we'll discuss that a little bit later in our future chapter. But this is a pretty darn big number. It's actually going to be 35 times 34 times 33 times 32 times yada 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 all the way down to times 4. If you multiply all those together, that's the different ways you can grab three different people out of a group of 35. So see here, in a population of only 35, the numbers of possible samples that could be taken is just huge. Now, if we do something like take everybody's name, assign it to a number, and then take a bunch of poker chips and write those numbers and throw them in a big bucket, shake up the bucket, reach in, grab one, shake up the bucket again, reach in, grab a different one, you're doing that without putting in the numbers you just drew, that would be an example of a simple random sample. Now, typically, we're going to use technology to do this with. And if you're using a TI-83 calculator or TC Stats or whatever technology you're using, you want to generate random integers. And typically the way you do that is simply specify how many integers. You're going to have a starting value, maybe 1, to an ending value, in this case 35. And then, like I said, the number of values. So you may start from 1, go to 35, and pick 3 numbers and tell the technology to use random integers. you would need to refer to resources for whatever you're using, the calculator, if you're using a calculator, or TC stats, to see how to actually generate those random numbers.